सेंट थॉमस इंग्लिश मीडियम हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल सूरत बाय धनंजय सिंह स्टैंडर्ड 12 चैप्टर नंबर 10 एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग इन जावा। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज एक्सेप्शन, हाउ टू हैंडल द एरर्स in our Java programming. So let us understand one by one. What is an exception? An exception is a problem that arises during the execution of a program. Basically, this occurs when we run our program or when we compile our the program. So that time this kind of the errors are coming. So we can say the exceptions are the errors which occur when we compile or run the program. An exception can occur for many different reasons, including the followings. So reasons are: a user has entered invalid data. Invalid data means, for example, if you try to divide a number by zero, then there will be chance to come a error. Because if you divide a number by zero, so you know any number cannot be divided by zero. So obviously the error will occur. Second example, suppose you try to access the array elements which is not in the list, then the error will be also occurred. Second, a file that needs to be opened cannot be found. Suppose you have tried to open such a file which is not existing, then the error will occur. And third one, a network connection has been lost in the middle of the communications, or the JVM has run out of memory. So these are the different situations where the error can come. Basically, what happened, friends? We are the developer, so we know what the errors are there and how to solve that error. But when we develop the software, so these softwares are handed over to a person, those who are willing to use. They don't have a knowledge about this software. They just know how to use it. That's why we need to give proper information to that person. If he or she is trying to do this kind of the thing, then he or she will understand what is happening inside the program. So in this lesson we will understand how to handle the errors. Now we're talking about types of exception. So as I told, exceptions means the errors which are occurring during the compilation time or execution time. Here are two types of errors in Java. The one, the compile time errors. Second, runtime errors. Compile, you know, the process of checking the bugs or the process of converting our Java programming to machine programming, that is called compilation. So if there is a mistakes done by you, that is called the typography mistakes, you have not written correct syntax, correct grammar, then the error will occur. That is called compile time errors. Sometime what happen, there is no mistakes in syntax, there is no mistakes in grammar, but what mistakes are coming? Logical mistakes. So this type of the errors are known as runtime errors. Means this error will not occur during the compilation, but when we run, so this type will error come. So these types of the errors occur during execution of the program, due to wrong logic or may terminate due to errors such as stack overflow. Or as I told that if you try to divide a number by zero, so this is logical mistakes. Okay, so how to solve this mistake? We have to use the concept exception handling. To handle the exceptions or errors in Java, we have a exception class. Here you can see here array index out of bound exception. This is used to handle in a such a situation where user tries to access the array elements which is out of a scope. Developer knows, but a person who is using your software doesn't know because he is not familiar with the programming. So we have to handle this kind of the errors using the array index out of bound exception. You can see here int a, and here the maximum array size is 4, but you are going to initialize a13 having the 99. So means you are going to put the index value a13 99, but you can see here the maximum size is 4, so here it cannot accept a13 because this index is not existing. Second example, you can see arithmetic exception, that is the array exception class. If user tries to divide any number by 0, to handle this kind of error we have to use this file not found exception. If you are trying to access the file which is not existing in your computer, then how to handle? To handle this we have to use file not found exception. Null pointer exception, an attempt to use null in a case where an object is required. You can see example is strings s is equal to null and system.out.print and s.length. Here you can see null means nothing and you are trying to get the length, so error will come. Number format exception. Number format exception means suppose you have declared a string and you are trying to convert into a number. It may be parse int, it may be parse float, it may be parse double. So it's not possible to convert. Only possible to convert from integer to float, float to integer, or double to float. It's not possible to convert a string to the this. So this kind of the error can occur. So how to handle? To handle, we have to use the number format exception. So these are the exception class which we have to use to handle the exceptions. The errors in Java programming. How to handle exception? So as we have already seen, an exception is an error condition. Exception handling is an object oriented techniques for managing errors. So we can say these are the techniques which are used to manage the errors. Java uses try, catch and finally to write an exception handler. So if you want to handle the errors or you want to use the exception handling concept, so Java provide the two things, the one try and catch, another it provide the finally. In the try block, just we give a code which may generate the error. The code which may generate the error will be written in the try block, and when there is a chance to come error or when the error comes, then catch block will catch it. So try block holds the code which we want to monitor for exception, or as I told that the code which may generate the error will be in the try block. A catch block contains the code that is intended to handle exception. of a particular type that we are created in try block. Means when the error comes in the try block, so then catch block will generate the message which type of the errors are coming in try block. Let us see the syntax for try and catch block. You can see the syntax of the try and catch is try, then curly bracket, then we give the set of statements that may generate one or more exceptions, or we can say that can create errors. And in the catch, we give exception type, which type of the exceptions will have to write, that will be there. And then in the curly bracket we have to show the message when the error comes. Let us see practically how this is going to be used. Let us see, friends, over here we are going to understand compile time error. You can see here I have not given a semicolon, and I'm going to just compile it. So if I click on this compile and run, so we will be see the error will be generated. Just a minute, wait, friends. You can see here the error will be generated, and you can see here, you can see, friends, the error, this it's going to show the error Java 5 means the line number 5. And the error, you can see the semicolon expected, and in which line is given here. So this is the compile time error. I hope you got it. So as I told, there are two types of the error. The one is compile time error, and second is runtime error. Now if I give here semicolon, now, and let me show you, friends, just a minute. Now I'm going to run it. Now you will be see there is no any error. You can see the answer is coming. Let me show you one more type of error. I'm going to declare here int a is equal to 45 and int b is equal to 0. And here I'm going to print A by B. If I see here, if I compile, means compile and run, so error will be not generated, but you will be see what will happen. You can see here, this is runtime error. Why runtime error? Actually here that there is a logical error. Logical error means, you can see this A has 45, B has 0. So 45 will not be divided by 0. We know that. If I remove this, if I put here 2, then you will be see, let me put 3 here, and if I run, so you will be see the answer will come. There is no any error. You can see the 15 is coming up, right? So here I explained the both kind of error. The one which is compile time error that comes while compilation, and second is logical error. As I have given example here, I am trying to divide any number by 0, you will be see the error is occurring, and this error is occurring while runtime, not while compilation. I hope it is very clear, right? Let me show you another kind of error. Here I am going to rough this, and here I am going to declare int, and let me show you the marks. Then I am going to declare here a number. And let me print here this value. I want to print marks. And here I am going to print of, let me put here 5. Let's see what is happening over here, friend. If I, let me rough this, if I run this, you will be see the error is coming. You can see here array index out of bound exception, index 5 out of bounds for length 4. You can see here the array size is 4. It can store a maximum 4 array elements, but here I am trying to access the marks 5, which is beyond of limit. So this is also a kind of error. If I give here 4, so what will happen? Let me show you. If I run, you will see what is coming. Again, the error is coming because this size is 4. I am trying to access the 5th array element because the index number starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, and this if you want to access the 4, so here we have to give the 3, then we are able to access because it starts from 0 then and the last n minus 1. Now if I run, so there will be no any error. You will be see the 4 is coming out, right? So here I have displayed you both kind of errors. The one is compile time error, another is logical error. In the logical I displayed the both. The one I try to divide a number by 0. Another I try to access a number which is beyond of limit, or we can say the number which is out of a scope of this array. So this error is coming. Now the question is that how to handle this error. To handle this error, we have to use the try and catch. So let us understand, friends, how to use the try and catch. I'm going to use try. You can see the try, then catch, and then exception. Here we have to mention the code which can generate the error. So here I'm going to write int a, and a is, let me give here 45. And then int b is equal to let me give here 0, and int c is equal to a by b. And here I want to show the appropriate methods. So let me run without giving the appropriate methods. Let me print here system.out, and let me print here this C, and let's see what is happening over here, friend. If I run this, see what is coming over here, friend. It's going to show the error over here. It's going to show this. You can see this is cannot find this symbol system.out.println. This C. Why this C is not going to print it? Let me see. And if I print this, if let me give here 2 and let me run it and let's check it. What is happening? You can see again the error is coming. Why this error is coming? Let me declare this all above. Just a second, friends. Above the try block, let me mention here try, and I want to mention the C. Okay, C also I want to mention here int C, and is equal to 0. I want to put initial value, right? Now let me run it and let me check it. So here I'm going to run this. Let's see. And here I want to put b as a 0 also, and let me run. You can see here the 0 is going to be printed. I'm going to print the c here, and the c has a 0, right? Let me print this syntax or we can say statement inside it, and let's see c is going to be printed or not. You can see nothing is going to be printed, but I want to print the appropriate message here. So let me print here system.out, and I want to print E. Let's see. You can see, friend, It's going to show that. What is going to show? java.lang.arithmeticException by 0. It means it's going to show we can't divide any number by 0. You can put an appropriate message also, like let me show you. I want to show here. You can't just a minute friends you cannot divide a number by 0. I want to show this along with this one. Now what will happen if it is going to divide by 0, then this will be executed, otherwise this will be not executed. Let me show you. If I run this, you'll be see this message is coming. Just a minute, you can see you can't divide a number by 0, right? I hope it is very clear. But if I give here, let me show, if I give here, I want to give here b is equal to, let me give here 3. So you'll be see this answer will come up. Let me rough and let me show you. If I run, you'll be see the result will come, 15 will come, right? Let me put appropriate message here. Here I want to divide this, I want to print b, then plus, then message here. Then plus, then I want to print here. Here I want to print A, then I want to print here B, then I want to print a message. Okay, now let me show. You can see the error is coming. Why the error is coming? Yeah, here we need a plus sign. Okay, now there will not come. Let's see. You can see 45 divided by 3 is 15. And if I here put a 0, then you will see the answer will not come. What will come? This will come. You can see. So here we are handling the error. You can see you can't divide a number. So we are going to use this exception handling, right? I hope it is very clear. Let me give another example. Here I am going to declare one. Let me rough this. Yeah. Let me give here marks. And here I'm going to give the different marks, right? And I'm trying to access this. Just I'm going to print marks. There's let me print here 0, 1, 2, let me print 3. And here I want to print only E. So let's see. And here we have to give the size. Now let me run it. You can see here we are getting the answer over here. Array index out of bound exception. So we are not able to access, because here I'm trying to access the index number 3, and this is beyond of this limit, because the maximum index number is 0, 1, 2. It's not a 3, but I'm trying to access the 3. If I give here 2, so you'll be see it will be give you 69 answer. There will be no error, you will see that. So here we are handling the errors using the try and catch block. So how to use this? Try holds the those code which may generate the error, and the catch will provide appropriate message when the error is trapped. So I hope it is very clear. We have to write the try, then the code which may generate the error. Then in the catch block, we have to provide the appropriate message when the errors are trapped. I hope it is very clear. Let us understand, friends, exception handling mechanism, how this is going to trap the error. So as we have already seen how to use try and catch block, you can see here the try block, which holds those statement which can generate error or which may arise error. So that will be in the try block. And as I have already shown you in the previous slides, if you try to generate the error, or maybe if errors are generated in the try block, then what will happen? That appropriate message will be displayed in the catch block. So you can see I have written here the statements that may cause exceptions of different type, then this catch block will be fire up. So it's very simple ki agar try block ke andar jo code diya hai uske andar agar error aati hai, agar wo error generate karta hai, exceptions aata hai, then this catch block will be fired, means it will be executed. Otherwise this catch block will not give any respond. So I hope it is very clear. Multiple catch blocks means in one program we can give multiple catch blocks, right? So if the try block throws several different kinds of exception, we can write multiple catch blocks, each handling a specific type of exception. This helps the programmer to write separate logic for each type of exception. So if you want to declare one try block with many catch blocks, you can. So let us see how to do this. Friends, you can see here I have used two catch blocks. You can see here. Let us start from the beginning. You can see it. Int marks 78, 98, 69. This is the array which is storing the three elements. The maximum size is 3. It can't take more than 3. And here the int a is 45. So here I am. The first try, I am going to print this marks 2. So marks 2 means 0, 1, 2, means 69 will be printed. If I try to, so here there will be no any error. Means and to handle this, I am going to use this one. Means when there is a array index out of bound exception, means if you try to access those array elements which is beyond of a scope, then this catch block will fire up. But if you try to divide a number by 0, then this catch block will be fire up, automatic exception. So as I promised you, I will show you how to use the multiple catch blocks. So you can see here I have used the one try block, but it has a many catch blocks. So two catch blocks, boxes we are going to use it. So it means it's very clear that in one program you can use a many catch blocks with one try block, and that catch blocks will be fire up according to the condition. Let me show you. If I run here, so what will happen? Here, this here I'm trying to access the 2, so it's possible to access 2 because the marks 2 means it will give you the 69. So and but here the error will be generated. And here I am trying to divide 45 by 0, so it's not possible. Let me run you, and you can see the one catch block is going to be run because we can't divide 45 by 0. So in one program we can use many catch blocks, and these catch blocks are executed as per the need of this program. Suppose if I make mistakes in all. Let me try it after the 4. So what will happen? Both the catch blocks will be fire off. You can see here, friends. You can see. This is, right? You can see. So both are going to be fire off. Because it's not possible. So I hope it is very clear.